is a part of who I am. And a skin cancer patient said, you know, I don't care about having a scar, but I just don't like the idea of having my face pulled out of shape. That is alarming to me. I'm a little worried about how it will affect my professional life. I don't want to be termed an object of pity, some kind of disfigured old hag. So you see that there are similarities between these three mediators: cancer worry, expectations, and appearance investment. The differences lie in how these three are expressed in these two groups of patients. So skin cancer patients explained that they changed their social behavior by avoiding vacationing in funny places, by wearing hats and long sleeves outside, and by wearing sunscreen on a daily basis. Head and neck patients, on the other hand, noted more psychological changes, including longer period of feelings of increased self-consciousness and embarrassment in social situations. The head and neck group experienced greater facial alterations compared to the skin cancer group. Yet despite this differentiation, the three mediators did remain the same between both groups of patients. So to summarize, we see that the mediators play an important role across these two groups, even though they lie on different areas of the spectrum of facial oncology patients. The high rate of cancer recurrence and the overlap of patients between the two groups also speak to the relevance of furthering our understanding of these mediators. Comparing the impact of altered facial appearance in a range of facial oncology patients allows for a better understanding of the relative impact associated with these different facial procedures and the subsequent degrees of altered facial appearance. Understanding the relationship of mediators with facial oncology patients improves our knowledge of patient needs and expectations. It often impacts the development of patient-specific outcome measures, and hopefully ultimately will play a role in improving decision-making between patient and provider and in patient care.
Extent the severity of the disfigurement of the patient.